WoW Classic Season of Discovery has got us searching all over for these new runes, and they can be all over the place, so I wanted to cover the first 6 easy runes you can get on a Warlock by level 10. And this is from the point of view as a Alliance Gnome Warlock, and it will be in the, everything is from the starter areas, so this should be quite an easy one to follow. You don't need to level too much for these, and once you've got these 6, you should be doing a lot of damage. I'll also cover a fast way to get the harder runes too later on, so if you want to subscribe, you'll see that video when it comes out. But let's get straight into it. First up, Haunt, a really powerful early game instant cast spell, and this is given to you by your class trainer at level 2. Once you've got it, just head southwest of the trainer to the Trogs. There's like a little chest at the very first thing you get to, and you just open the chest and the rune is inside. It's that simple, it's that easy, you just need to know where it is. And that's it, the first rune, done. Next, Chaos Bolt. I'd say you should go for Chaos Bolt because it is incredibly powerful early on. You can hit over 100s even below level 10, and you don't need to fight anything to get it. You just head over to Golbalar Quarry, which is on the southeast of the start zone where all the Trogs are, and there's a frozen Trog in the middle. And you need to cast 4 fire spells at the same time to break it out of the ice. The easiest way to do this is to have 2 Warlocks, as your Imp counts as a firecaster. So if you get 2 Warlocks here, you both get your Imps out, and then you cast Immolate while attacking with your Imps. That counts as 4 people all casting fire spells, and it will melt the ice in seconds, and then you just go over and grab the rune off the body. If you can't find any Warlocks, you might want to get a couple of mages, so just go into general chat and just ask for help, or just ask the people that are passing by, and you should easily get this one. With Haunt and Chaos Bolt, you've got some really powerful spells that should really ramp your damage up early on. But now let's get some other ones that just improve your build. So Demonic Grace, that should be the third one you can go for. A buff that gives you increased dodge and increased crit rate. If you pop Demonic Grace before Chaos Bolt, you have massive burst damage. And to do this, you need to collect a bunch of items and then go summon a demon and defeat it. I'll tell you how to do it, and then I'll tell you a little easy way to do it afterwards as well. So first, you want to get the Wolf Jawbone, which drops from wolves, which are like the first things you fight in the game anyway. Next, you want to go fight some Wendigos around the middle of the map. I'll put them all on screen. And then they drop Wendigo blood. And then finally head to the southwest in this cave and fight the Troll Shadowcasters as they drop Ominous Tomes. Once you have these 3 items, you want to head over to Shimmer Ridge, which is the X on this map, and there is a pedestal to summon a demon. Summon the demon and fight it, and that's how you get this Demonic Grace rune. Now here's the easy option. With how busy Classic Season of Discovery is right now, if you just go over to Shimmer Ridge with I don't know, 1 item, no items, whatever, and just hang around, somebody will summon this demon. I was here and it kept getting summoned over and over again. And you can just get experience for fighting it and defeat it, and you still get the rune. That's what I did. Anyway, on to number 4, Soul Siphon. Soul Siphon changes like Life Drain, Soul Drain, and makes everything stronger, and you want to head to the southeast of the map here, past the quarry, and fight your way past some level 10 mobs, some dwarven mobs, and into this house at the very back. Once you have Fear and Chaos Bolt, this is very easy. You just want to get into this room and get down to the bottom where Captain Beld is. And you want to go down, fight everyone. You want to defeat everyone on the way down, get to Captain Beld, and then fight him. And as he's dying, you want to use Drain Soul, as if you were trying to get a soul crystal out of him. And you'll get a tainted soul shard. Now you want to go find a critter. So think like a rabbit or some small animal that is like level 1 that doesn't fight back. And you want to use the same ability. You want to use Drain Soul on a critter. And that will give you a pure soul. With these 2, the Tainted Soul and the Pure Soul, you want to go back to Karanos, you know, the starting zone, and you want to talk to Gaklik, which is the Warlock Trainer. Give him both of these items and you'll get the Soul Siphon rune. I heard you can also get the Tainted Soul from other people around this area, but this one definitely works and is not that hard if you're level 10. Okay, next on to Master Channeler. Now, I said that Haunt was the easiest rune. I think it's this one. This one is incredibly easy. You can probably get this at level 1 if you're feeling brave enough. And it's Master Channeler. This changes how Drain Life works. You want to head east out of Dalmora into Loch Medan, and you'll find the little outpost when you get here. And at this outpost where you learn like Defense of the King's Lands, you know, this one, there's a path up from this all the way to the outpost at the top of the map. It's a straight path all the way up. And a traveling trader walks up and down this path, and you just want to find him. You can head out up the path and look for him, or you can just wait near the entrance for him to walk down to you. And his name is Gratian Ironstove. When you find him, buy a malevolent pie off him for 5 silver and eat the pie. That's it. You just find him, buy the pie, eat the pie, and you get the channeling rune. Really simple, really easy, and a pretty nice rune for how much effort it takes. Okay, now finally, the 6th one, the last one you can get really early on, is Demonic Tactics. Now this requires a little bit of traveling, but it's still very doable as level 10 because it's all in starter zones and going through towns. I'd love to know if this is available in Loch Medan or Dalmora or one of the gnome starting zones, but I've only seen it in Elwyn Forest. That's the only place I was able to find it. So you want to head over there. Once you're in Elwyn, you want to head north of Crystal Lake, which is here on the map, near the mine, like left of the mine. And there's a little statue here and a body. You want to interact with this body and it will give you a bag, open it up, and there's a note and an artifact. Now, there's a couple of clues here, but basically it tells you you want to go and give this to somebody. You want to go to Goldshire, which is just west of this place, still in the same area. Go to Goldshire, there's a little town, and there is an inn. Go to the bottom of the basement of the inn, and there's a warlock trainer there. Talk to him, and he will give you another item. Now you go back to the body you found. So take the item back to the body, another walk all the way back to the body, and use the item. As soon as you use this item, you've got like a time thing starting. So you want to make sure you've got enough time to do this because there's a 10-minute timer on this. The second you use the item, you get a 10-minute debuff. Now, what you need to do is run back to Stormwind. This debuff makes you 50% weaker, so don't fight anything. Just run straight back to Stormwind. Go to Stormwind, then go to the Mage District, and you want to go to the west side of the Mage District. I'll show everything on screen. And there's another Warlock trainer. Talk to him, and he will cleanse the debuff for you. Once he cleanses the debuff, you get the rune. So that's it. A little bit of a walk, but there's nothing to fight here. So there's no stress coming over here as a gnome. But that's it. Once you've done this, you'll have 6 runes by about level 10, level 11, and that's it. You'll feel very powerful. You know, Horn, Chaos Bolt, Demonic Tactics. All these things make you feel very tanky, very powerful. And you've only got like 1 minion and probably bad gear, but you still feel like you can 2 or 3 hit things. It feels very strong early game as a warlock. Once you get these, the next ones are kind of harder to get. They require you to be much higher levels, or they require you to get into groups or go to more dangerous areas of the maps, or some need like 4 or 5 gold to buy. So I wanted to just make a simple video that covers the 6 that pretty much anybody can get by level 10. So I really hope this helps. And if you want to see a harder one of maybe an easy and fast way to get the harder runes, let me know in the comments and subscribe if you want to see that. I'm going to wrap it up here. Season of Discovery has been incredible so far. I hope you're all enjoying it as much as I am. I hope you're having fun. But that's it for this video. Take care, everybody, and I'll catch you in the next one.